the Satans, and Satan was ungrateful to his Lord. On the other hand, avoiding extravagance should not be misunderstood as to mean avoiding the gifts of God. He states in the Quran, "Eat and drink, but do not be profligate." He does not love the profligate. In this verse, God has told believers to enjoy His gifts and has forbidden them only to spend wastefully. Today, however, in societies remote from religion, extravagance is not paid the attention it is due. In restaurants and houses, plates of food, pounds of bread, fruits and vegetables are thoughtlessly thrown away. But God has forbidden extravagance, whether in significant or insignificant amounts. Therefore, people should try to find a way to make use of all gifts before they spoil, instead of throwing them away saying, "This has gone off," or "We cannot use this." Only in this way they can give these gifts their due value. Otherwise, the result is scarcity and ingratitude to God. How is jealousy referred to in the Quran? Envy is condemned in the Quran. God has revealed that He created the soul of mankind prone to envy, but that believers should be wary of it. But people are prone to selfish greed. If you do good and have fear of God, God is aware of what you do. Jealousy comes as a result of not accepting that somebody else is superior to oneself. This indeed is an attitude which may lead a person even to haughtiness against God, because it is God who grants people everything they possess. He gives as He wills, and no one can ever prevent this. Apart from this, it is also related in the Quran that Satan rebelled against God by not prostrating himself before Adam. We are informed that he regards himself superior to Adam. So we face an important fact at this point. Jealousy is in fact an attribute of Satan, and anyone who fears God should strictly avoid it. Where does calling others by offensive nicknames stand in the Quran? People who do not live by the religion of God deride other people by calling them by offensive nicknames in attempt to dishonor them and thus exalt themselves. Believers, on the other hand, never behave in such a poor manner. God strictly prohibits believers from doing so, stating that those who do not obey this injunction are evildoers. You who believe, people should not ridicule others who may be better than themselves, nor should any woman ridicule other women who may be better than themselves. And do not find fault with one another or insult each other with derogatory nicknames. How evil it is to have a name for evil conduct after coming to faith. Those people who do not turn from it are wrongdoers. Those who conform to the morals of the Quran never behave in this indecent way, which is disapproved of by God. they address each other in the most pleasing way and deeply respect each other as sincere servants of God. What does the Quran say about mockery? Mockery is an example of poor morality which God certainly does not approve of. There are many manifestations of mockery in irreligious societies, including mocking the imperfections or defects of others, and calling one another by unpleasant nicknames. In the Quran, God warns people against this evil act as follows. Woe to every fault-finding backbiter. Another type of mockery referred to by God in the Quran is that of believers by unbelievers. It is revealed in the Quran that, unable to grasp that the believers were on the true path, people who believed themselves to be superior to the believers mocked them. Some of the verses on this subject read, those who did evil used to laugh at those who believed. When they passed by them, they would wink at one another. Yet, God reveals that these people are greatly mistaken and heralds the tragic end they will come to as follows. So today, those who believe are laughing at the disbelievers on couches, gazing in wonder. Have the disbelievers been rewarded for what they did? Furthermore, God describes in the Quran those who hold Islam and His revelations to mockery, and reveals that these people reject every warning from God and His messengers. They are the people who do not measure the power of God to its full extent, and ignore the fact that they will be judged in His presence. Yet these people will be bewildered in the hereafter and will be repaid for the mockery they used to engage in. This fact is clearly mentioned in the Quran as, those are the people who reject their Lord's signs and the meeting with Him. Their actions will come to nothing, and on the day of rising, we will not assign them any weight. That is their repayment, hell, because they disbelieved and made a mockery of my signs and of my messengers. What is the place of gossip in the Quran? In the Quran, God forbids believers from backbiting and refers to it as an indecency. Do not backbite one another. Would any of you like to eat his brother's dead flesh? No, you would hate it. And heed God. God is ever returning, most merciful. As commanded by this verse, people who live by the religion and are like brothers and sisters to each other strictly avoid this behavior. On the contrary, believers remember only each other's good intentions and always try to highlight their good attributes. They do not try to find defects or faults in those who are submissive to the will of God. Gossip is a corruption that never exists among believers who maintain the limits set by God. When believers notice an imperfection or other defect in another, they do not backbite, but instead admonish the person directly so that he will amend his unacceptable behavior. How is suspicion defined in the Quran? Acting on suspicion and conjecture is another thing God